Hello again, folks. Welcome to the next episode of Joxa Playing Skyrim, the Argonian Mage. In the previous episode, we set off to find out something about the Galdor legend. And we've been traveling home, and I've been doing my equipment, etc. And I'm ready to go and delve into this dungeon and have a look at what's going on in here. It's right over here, Fol Gunthor. That should be quite interesting. I also remembered the mother's name, Apple Stormy. Apple Stormy, if you end up watching this, I'm really sorry for not remembering your name. Seriously guys, if you want to liven up your world for Skyrim a little bit, try installing those city mods from Apple Stormy. They are so well worth it. Let's get going, and I'm really interested in what's going on in this dungeon here. It should be quite exciting. Is everybody still with me? Yeah, they're going. It should be right here somewhere. Oh, there's like bugs and stuff. There you go, some dart wings. And this is where we need to go. There's a camp nearby. Thanks, Gary. You just flew my horse away. Ah, a book. Or a journal. How long has it been since I... text. One, chew. Since I first, heard the Galdor legend. 80 years, 100, I can think of nothing else now. My goal is at hand. After years of searching, I finally traced the ivory claw to a collector in Braville. His death was necessary, but I have it. At last, I have it. 3 days of non-stop riding, I reached Anvil Head with of my pursuers, and took passage on the Ice Runner, bound for Solitude once more. The other passengers are becoming suspicious. Returning from dinner, I caught one brute rooting around in my quarters. He almost found the claw. Had the captain not intervened, I would have flayed him alive. I hope to spend the voyage sequestering in my room, reviewing my notes and preparing spells, but I need to deflect some attention from myself. I'll have to mingle, pretend to be just another petty mage for now. The brute claims to be an adventurer. Off to seek his fortune in the ruins of Skyrim with his companions. Perhaps I can turn this to my advantage. Use them as fodder for the traps and drawware within the tombs. I can see the greed in his eyes. Yes, that should work. 3 weeks to Solitude, the captain says. If I have to suffer these fools longer than that, I'll swim. With the brute and his companions in tow, I led our band across the marsh to Fol Gunthor, where we made camp for the night. Little has changed since my first expedition 10 years ago, but this time I have the claw, and I will have the amulet. I spent all night preparing a synopsis of my notes, in case some fragment of the tale or piece of ancient lore may be needed to bypass the wards within the tomb. Then I cast all my books and scrolls into the fire and reduced my life's works to ashes. At long last, today is the day of reckoning. If I cannot have the amulet, no one will. The thing is, I have the amulet. I have the Galdor amulet. There you go, it's an amulet fragment. Interesting. And I got that from the mage questline. There's nothing else near. Guess we need to go inside then. Or not. Yeah, we need to go inside. This will prove to be ladies? Ladies, we're leaving. It's one. Did I hear a dragon roaring? I thought I heard a dragon roar. There's a dragon there! I'm never gonna be in time. This is so unfair. This is like the ultimate unfairness. Can I make it? To that side, up on the cliff, attack him. I need to try it. I'm the Dragonborn. I need to do this. Mount up. We're leaving. I must save Solitude. Come on, Horsey. Horsey, you better know how to swim. Ah, so slow. Why can't I like use fly or something? I could just fly up to the dragon and zap him in the face. Ugh, it's so slow. I'm sorry guys, I need to try this. I need to. I've been wanting to kill a dragon or fight a dragon or something. I saw a shade. Where are you, lizardy fiend? Where is he? Somewhere over there.
Take care with those flames.
Shop guards. Ah, come on, there's no top. Ah, you can't even get on top of this tower. Where is he? Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Why? Useless. How do I fight that dragon then? Dude, there's a dragon over there. You don't want to be walking there. Yeah, there we go. Now we've got your attention. This is a hard dragon. Oh boy. This is gonna go really, really bad. I would like you guys to take note of my health. That's almost non-existing. Elder Dragon, huh? Okay. Okay. There we go. Don't stand in my way then. Good fight, come on. Oh, don't land on top of me. Don't stand in front of me. Yeah, using a ice staff on a ice dragon doesn't really work now, does it? Yeah, there we go. Ah, so much better. Your soul, please.
Imagine okay. blowing up an entire town. Damn college. Winterhold would never be the same. If you need potions, head over to Angeline's aromatics.
Dragon soul absorbed. That was definitely worth it. I know, right? It's amazing. Okay, back where we came from. And sorry for the detour, folks. I hope you appreciate me actually going out and hunting dragons. In this case, I really wanted to test out the battle. What did you guys think about that battle? It felt like the difficulty was about right. The dragon was able to put up a good fight. I easily ran out of my magicka. I had to resort to my staff to actually do some damage to him. So I think that wasn't too bad of a fight. The dragon difficulty I think is pretty well. But if you guys think differently, let me know in the comments below, and I will consider changing things up a little bit. So in the next episode, we will be actually doing that Fulgunthor place, just because we had a little bit of a detour for the dragon. I have so many dragon souls at the moment that I might actually consider switching one for a perk point. Sorry, switching 5 for 1 perk point. Sounds like a pretty good deal like that. Fulgunthor should be here-ish, right? Ah, there. Took me a second to find where we were. There we go. Just putting the dragon bones in horsey. Yes, and yes. All done. But yeah, that's basically it. Let's have a look at switching around the... how did you do it again? I think you had to go to the configuration. Was it part of Deadly Dragons? No? Yes? No? There you go, 5 souls for 1 perk point. How many souls do I have? Magic, shouts... And I have 9. I think I can miss like 5. I've got plenty of those. So, Deadly Dragons, Miscellaneous, Convert 1, Select. It's not working. Enter. It says I have 4 Dragon Souls. Why does it say I have 4 Dragon Souls? Something get derpy. Magic. Dragon Souls. 4. Oh! Apparently when you click it doesn't give you a confirmation. I get it now. Skills. Let's see. Yeah, there you go. Perk points. Sweet. So I've got 1 perk point to play around with. I'll probably end up taking a look at my skills later and change things appropriately. Well, thus far it's looking pretty well. I'm very pleased with the outcome. What is this? Expert Illusion. Ooh. That's tempting. Well, we'll think about it. And it looks like my illusion is actually almost ready to go for the Master Spell Illusion. And yes, I've been waiting for Serana to get here. Hi, Serana! Oh, and even my Dromora Lord is here as well. Okay, folks, my time is about to go in 1 second. So, folks, as always, I will be right back.